Please be aware of exceptions. Look at this question. What answer did you get? Did you get A or D? That is not correct. Look at statement 1. X is greater than minus 1. If X is equal to something like 1, the answer is yes. If X is something like negative 0.5, the answer is no. See, nowhere it is written that X is an integer. X can very well be a fraction such as this. Yes and no both are possible. So statement 1 is not sufficient. Look at statement 2. Mod of X is equal to X. One would think that this is possible only for positive values of X, such as 1. Mod of 1 is equal to 1. For cases such as negative 0.5, this would not hold. And some students may mark statement 2 as sufficient. However, there is one exception, and that exception is 0. Mod of 0 is equal to 0. If X is equal to 0, this condition is satisfied that mod X is equal to X. And what is the answer to this question? Is X positive? The answer in this case would be no. So even in second case, there is one exception because of which statement 2 becomes insufficient and combining would not help, because even on combining we can take a 1 and we can take a 0. In 1 we will get yes, in 0 we will get no. So even combining does not help. The answer is option E. And the main learning from this slide is to be aware of the exceptions. GMAT very often makes questions where answers change because of such exceptions, such as the one illustrated here. This was the concept, guys. GMAT shorts are deliberately kept brief. For an elaborate explanation, please refer the stage 1 videos. Thanks for watching.